Grandma's Kitchen.
There's a fiddle tune and a wooden spoon while she's stirring and singing. There's friends leaving our family land, and then the phone's usually ringing. No matter who you are or what you've done, everything's forgiven.
Thank God.
Grandma's Kitchen.
And ain't it good to be in
Grandma's Kitchen?
Hello, everybody. Mary Janet here from Tunes and Wooden Spoons, and welcome back for another visit to my Cape Breton kitchen here in Port Hood. So you heard that little bitty guitar music, and that was Nick the Pick. And I'm so happy to have my guest today is Dolores Boudreaux, and the guitarist is Nick Boudreaux, who is back again. You've seen him before with Robert Bouchard here in this house, so that's always nice to have him back here. And we're also welcoming Everett Bass, sorry, Dolores's friend, who is, and all three are from Isle Madame, so I'm so happy to have them. Well, I hope you all had a wonderful week. I just had a week of wonderful memories and just great stuff happening in my life this past week. Well, when I left you last Sunday, we were sitting down to Thanksgiving dinner. And then on Monday, Thanksgiving Day, we all went over to Mitchell's for Thanksgiving dinner. So we were gobbling by the end of the night. And thank God I got a book like this. So let's see. On Tuesday, I went for a facial and a pedicure with my friend, Heather. Thank you, Heather. It was a wonderful day. I would encourage anybody who hasn't to go do that for yourself. It's a wonderful, wonderful opportunity. And then on Wednesday, I stayed home and prepped for Thursday. I did a workshop at the Storytellers Gallery in Jüttig, and we did preserves, and I did jam and chow there. And then on Friday, I went to the Celtic Colors Close to the Floor concert in at Member 2, and as part of the Celtic Colors show. So that was wonderful. And yesterday I had my wonderful uncle from Edmonton. He's home for a month, he and his wife Charlotte, and we had lunch here with my sister Bernice as well. So it's just been fabulous. Every day on their own couldn't be any better. So as well, on Friday, it was Charlie's birthday. Charlie turned 8, and that's my grandson. For anybody out there who doesn't know Charlie, he turned 8 on Friday, and he had a very happy day with lots of his friends, as only Charlie could celebrate. And coming up this Friday, Mitchell's birthday, and his son Asher is turning 2. So happy birthday all around to all of those wonderful people. I also want to say a very special hello to somebody who is an avid follower every week. And she lives in South Bar near Sydney, and her name is Mary Beth Roper. Hi, Mary Beth. I'm so glad that you tune in every week and you love to bake. So I hope I get to meet you someday, because it would be pretty special. So that was Helen McDonald that let me in on a little secret that you are an avid follower, so it's so nice to see you. So today we are going to make quiche and my version of potato pancakes that I've been making since a long time. And so I'm going to start out by doing the crust first, and I am using my tart pan, the bottom comes out of it. So I have to make the crust big enough that it comes up to the sides. And if you're using, this is a 9-inch tart pan, so anybody out there with a tart pan, you can use your tart pan. But if you want to, if you don't have a tart pan, you can use a 9-inch pie plate, and that should be sufficient. And when you're making the crust, I'm just going to make the crust very shortly, but as we've made crusts together before for our pies, so if you're ahead of the game and have that already, that's just great. But I am going to use the full recipe for the tart pan because of the extra size of this. It's about 1.5 inches tall here, so I need to make the two crust recipe. But if you just are using a 9-inch pan, you can get away with halving that recipe and rolling it out just for that. And so I want you to preheat your oven to 350 if you're baking with me today. And I am going to go wash my hands, and I'll be right back with you. And the day is kind of cloudy here, but we had an absolutely brilliant week. And yesterday when I was coming home from Sydney, going over Kelly's Mountain, I swear I've never seen, the leaves were absolutely brilliant. Red and orange, just so awesome. Okay, I'll be right back. Lots of people. Oh, I know, Cheryl. The Celtic Colors, it was absolutely fantastic. So much talent. So much talent. Okay, I'm going to get started with the crust. And so I'm going to turn you over this way. Hello from Kingsville, Ontario. Okay, I will turn it down so you can follow along. There we go. Okay, so I'm making the double crust, so I'm going to use 2 cups of flour. And I'm going to take a little extra flour to have. Oh no, I have some already out there. And I'm going to put a teaspoon of salt in there. I'm just going to mix that up a little bit. This is a recipe that I learned in junior high when I was going to home economics class at school, and I still use the very same recipe today. And this Friday is conference day in Nova Scotia for teachers, and I am going to make cinnamon rolls with, I think they're called food and nutrition teachers now, but basically they are the home economics teachers, making that with them on their conference day, just on Zoom. So that'll be an experience, and it's just kind of full circle. It's so awesome. Okay, now into this I put 2/3 cup of shortening, or you can use butter if you like. I kind of tend to lean towards room temperature, just easier for me. I'm always in a hurry when I'm baking, so I tend to take the easy route. So, because sometimes they say, and it's probably the science is there, that having cold butter, cold shortening to cut in is the best way, and you get a flakier crust. But I'm content with my crust the way it is. It's
It's okay. So when I'm mixing it like this, it's actually coming together almost in a dough, but not quite. And I mean, we've done this together for our pies before, and it's the exact same recipe that I'm going to use. So, and I have water in a glass that I had, it's nice and cold. I had put 2 ice cubes in it, and now the ice cubes are melted. So, you can see how it looks, and it's nice and crumbly and will almost stick together, but it needs water. All right. So I'm going to put just about 6 tablespoons of water in there. 4, 5, and maybe 5.5. Let's see. Hopefully that will keep it all together. I tend to have mine, it's a bit on the wet side, but I really like it. I find I have more control over it that way. So now that's all coming together. Okay, so there you go. If yours is like that, or you're watching on the replay, that's really great. Okay, so I'm going to sprinkle some flour on my little mat here, baking mat. Normally, I just make it on the counter. So I basically sprinkle a flour on it until it's not really sticky. And I'll pray to God that it will come off the baking mat. It'll be just like me to not work while I'm doing it in front of you all. We'll patch it up. So I'm lucky that this is the great mat. It's an OXO mat, and I think I got it at Bed Bath & Beyond a long time ago. So keep your rolling pin full of flour so that it's not sticking. So that should be good. The thing I find with the tart pan is the edges are really sharp. So I don't want to roll up my pastry on my rolling pin for this. I'm going to be a little gentler here. Okay. Whew, that worked. So now I'm going to take it over here and I'm just going to lift the ends up and push it down so that it's into the corner and just let it drape over. Okay, and once it's in the tart pan, I'm just going to press down on it. And I'm just going to push it up against those little wavy lines so that it'll be in the pastry. Take it out. That's it, just like that. Okay, you can see that, and I'm going to put that aside, and we're going to mix up our quiche, which won't take very long, and then we'll be able to listen to some great singing by Dolores. And I don't like using leftover pastry for anything. I just don't. So I'm sorry. Usually I'm what they call scotchy. I try not to waste too many things, but when it comes to pastry, I'm not interested. So this is going to be sent away somewhere. We won't say where. Okay, I'm just gonna wash my hands. Back to you in a second. See, how are yous all doing? Lots of people on today watching. That's great. I see some hearts. Hi, Susan and Marilyn from Catherine Walmsley. Nancy Gifford is watching. Darlene McDonald Johnson. Hi, Diane from Tillsonburg, Ontario. Okay, back at it. We're gonna get into the quiche now, okay? Mary Frances LeBlanc, see you. Oh, you do, you make a galette from the leftover pastry. Very good. Hi, Susan Lundy. She was on the Cape Breton tour. Okay, so, I'm just going to get rid of this for now. And we're going to make our quiche. So it's six eggs from just down the road. Our neighbor. Nice fresh eggs. It's wonderful. It's just wonderful to live in Cape Breton on the morning of when the Cape Breton tour bus were coming and I was making cinnamon rolls and I was up early. I was able to go to my neighbor's house and go into her fridge and borrow milk. And, you know, it's great to have neighbors like that when you live around here. Okay, six eggs. So I'm going to whisk the eggs. And into that, I'm going to add 3/4 cups of milk. And I'm gonna have some salt and pepper. Probably, I don't know, what do I say? I don't usually measure out these ingredients. I'm throwing things in as I'm making it, but with you guys, I feel like I need to tell you how much. Okay, now that's your basic quiche there. And, first of all, I am going to shred my onion here. I'm going to shred the whole onion because I'm going to use half of the onion in the potato pancakes that we make a little bit later after the singing. Because you want to make the potato pancakes right when you're going to serve them. And I find that little shredder of mine, I don't like it for onions. So I have to do this the old-fashioned way, and I'll be shedding some tears. go. All the bigger pieces, I'm not gonna use, because I don't like biting into a darn onion. And there goes my eyes. So, I'm going to put half of that in, save the rest, and you can put in, as you know, I gave you lots of ideas of what you can put in. I cooked some ham before, just those little, those circle pieces of ham that are boneless pieces of ham, and took the rind off, cut it into little squares, and just fried it in some butter. So I'm going to add that. And I really never measure the spinach, so about that much, which is in it. And I don't cut it up, but you can cut it up if you like. This is about 2 cups of spinach. And you mix that up. And we're going to add some cheddar. So I'm going to take you over to the counter. And I'm going to shred some cheddar. And I'm just guessing that it's about a cup I might add. And then I'm going to add a little extra because I'm going to put some cheddar on the top. That is. That's a little over a cup, but I'm going to add a little bit extra so that I can sprinkle it on the top. What kind I'm using is old cheddar, because I like old cheddar. I don't like the mild stuff. So this there's a measure of about 1 cup in this little bowl. I'm going to add that in. And just put that around. And we're almost ready to put it in the oven. And then we'll have some singing. Full, and it will raise up a little bit more, but it's fine. So we're going to put it in for 40 minutes, and about 10 minutes before it's going to come out of the oven, we'll make the potato pancakes, okay? So here we go. Into the oven it goes. And yes, I put some suggestions on there of what you can add. Yes, somebody just said green peppers, so depending on who's visiting and what they want and if I'm eating. So
There's I put fried bacon pieces, fried ham, onion or onion powder if you don't want that onion in there, but you can get the flavor of the onion. Broccoli, spinach, mushrooms, green peppers, diced or red peppers. Lots of choices. You pick what you want in it, or if you just want it plain with just the meat in it or just the egg, it's great. And I made it on Tuesday. I made it on Tuesday, and Cecil and I had it reheated on Wednesday morning, and then again on Thursday. There was one piece left, and it was still just as good, just zapped up a little bit. Okay, so hold on a second. I'm gonna put it in the oven. So 40 minutes. You guys are great. You guys are just wonderful. Okay, we're gonna go to some music now. I'm gonna take you into my living room. We're going to have a great little visit here with these friends. And Elliot is here. He's just watching. He usually just sings in church, but he's just sitting there relaxing, just the life of Riley. And here we have Nick. Where's Nick? That way. Hey, Nick. And the lovely lady herself, Dolores.
Hello.
Hi, Dolores.
Hi.
And actually, you know what? I think I'm going to bring this down a little bit. Sorry, folks. So, there, we want to get the two of you in there, and a little bit closer. How's that?
Great. Perfect.
So, I'm just going to sit here for a second. So, who is Dolores Boudreau? Well, she just did a matinee for Celtic Colors. She's been singing her heart out since she was a little girl. And Dolores taught all of our children, except for Mitchell, French when she was here at Port Hood Consolidated School. And she's got a lovely voice. And, oh, somebody said hi from St. Peter's. I don't know who that was. But anyway, I am so happy that we finally got together and she's able to sing today for us and bring you some great music, Cape Breton music, French, just old traditional ones as well. So, please welcome Dolores Boudreau.
Thank
and
you.
Nick, that handsome fellow there.
So fair.
right beside you.
Okay.
Let me just peek my head around you here. Okay. So, Dolores, how has life been?
Life has been very busy.
Yeah.
Very rewarding.
Yes.
Yeah, it's all good.
It's all good. Have you been singing an awful lot lately?
Since COVID, yes. On film, on video,
okay.
So a lot of different things were produced.
Yes.
To be shown online. My first live audience was at Celtic Colors last summer, taped for last week, and that was a rush because it had been so long since I had seen eyes. And
yeah. Oh my God. And it just makes you glow and happy. And
yes.
I know that you, not only do you do this, but you also are very involved in your church and give your music to the church as well every week. Is
yeah.
it every week?
It's pretty well every week. My partner and I, Everett Bass, we sing in church, just like we sat in the United Church, two different United Churches, and so far three different Catholic churches. So we kind of do music on a rotation basis. And yeah, it's a lot of fun because Everett has a baritone voice, and I, of course, have what God gave me. They're so different that they actually go together.
Work together well.
Yeah.
I know he's not singing today, but I wonder if we could convince him to sing even a church song at the end.
Ah.
Well, we're putting him on the spot here, but I think he's a fella that might just go for that.
Well, I actually took one just in case.
Ah, yeah, there you go.
It's one we sang this morning in church, so it was right there, handy.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Well, listen, I let you take it away for the next two or three. I'll let you know when there's 10 minutes left, and
okay.
I'll start teaching them the potato pancakes, and
okay.
then we can, I'll get the plates ready, and maybe you guys could sing one more then, or something like that. Whatever works. Whatever works.
I just want to mention that being here for the first time in this environment, in the kitchen, in the house, I'm realizing that Mary Janet is the producer, and she's also the director, she's the cameraman, she's the lead actor, the scroll, it's just all herself, and that's pretty impressive, I think.
Oh, God. We'll see. The taste, thank you, Dolores.
Yeah. Inverness County has really given us quite a crop of musicians, quite a gift in the talent that it has given us. And I have to start in Mabo with the Rankin family and one of the brothers, Jimmy Rankin, who is such an amazing songwriter. We're going to do one of his right now. And it's really fitting for us because it's Fisherman's Son. We come from Isle Madame, where there is a lot of fishery. And so we'll give this a good try. I'm a fisherman's son, got fisherman's ways. I fished with my father in my young days. I learned the fine craft of the fisherman's trade. Just to pass with my son, so we'll be the same. Sea's my lifeline, the shore is my home. may not know that Nick here is a bluegrass musician. However, when he's by himself, we can't call him a bluegrass musician, but he has spent much of his life playing bluegrass music, loving it, and playing it well, I have to add. So we threw in a bluegrass song today. You'll have to imagine the mandolin and the banjo and the dobro. That 35 years ago, I taught school in Port Hood, right here. And this kitchen, and especially the kitchen in the previous house, which was yes. on this lot before this one, yes. There was an awful lot of music in that kitchen. But there was also an awful lot of laughter. And I can hear both equally from those days gone by. And there was increasingly as well a lot of love with each child that came on and now a whole whack of grandchildren that yes. I see on the fridge. So it's really wonderful. This is a good place. It's got a good energy. And those of you who are tuned in and have been all along know what Mary Janet delivers. So what are we going to do, Nick? We're going to come. Oh, let's do Peggy Gordon. Oh, my God. I remember two records when I was a little girl, and those two records came out almost simultaneously, and one of those records was Robert Bouchard, the Irish and countrysides of Robert Bouchard, and I love the Irish side. Somehow Celtic music got into my cells before I even came trotting along and step dancing in Inverness County. But the other album was John Allan Cameron. Here comes John Allan. He was wearing a kilt and he had his acoustic guitar strapped over his shoulder. And on that album, I love every song, by the way, even the Gaelic ones, which I sing phonetically, and I'm sure Rune, being a little Frenchman. But this was on there, and I've always love this song, and it's quite a long song. John Allan did it so well that he just knew how to come and reach us, especially live, because he was such an entertainer. Alrighty. Janet has some fans on Alma Dam and up in Shetty Camp and then throughout the rest of the Francophone areas of the province. But then there's New Brunswick and PEI and then La Belle Province, Le Québec and so on. So yeah, we'll just throw one in there. So this song is about eating. It's perfect. It's also about drinking. We only drink tea here.
Yeah.
But it's about friends and family and fun and love and laughter, so it just fits in like a glove.
Accueillant les gens autour de table, apportez-nous les miches de pain blanc. Accueillant les gens autour de la table, apportez-nous les miches de pain blanc. Faites remonter les pâtes sur la table, une cipaille et des paires de lumière. Vive le
This is a wonderful treat today. I'm having withdrawals from watching Celtic Colors every day. I know, but the great part of that is you can go back on YouTube and watch some of the shows. You can watch Dolores's on Lewisburg that day. It was wonderful. Oh, my gosh. Yes. So, anybody else have any? Oh, thank you for buying the cookbooks. Thank you, thank you. So does anybody have any questions or any requests of Dolores? She has a nice little song list here, but maybe you have some questions. Oh, yes, Mary Frances LeBlanc wants to hear Everett. We will. He hasn't said yes yet, but I'm not even going to look at him.
How can I refuse?
We're doing it. Hi, Noelle. Diane Cameron. But no, it's great. Hi, Tina. Lots of great Cape Bretoners from far and wide, you know, yes. And they're everywhere. And it's so nice. It's so nice to see. And lots. Yes, you know what? For those who are looking, somebody wants more French. But anybody who is looking for the cookbook, the second printing is... They're being delivered this week to the publishers. So they will restock at all of the places that have requested to have stock in. And they should be available on Amazon and on the ilovebooks.ca. Be great. Belle chanson, merci. Oh my goodness, how bad is that? But anyway,
it's all
from
good.
Montpellier, Quebec. Hi, Louise Monet. Monette, Monet. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. And so anyway, I hope you're enjoying this as much as I am. I'm just in the kitchen dancing away and enjoying this while I wait for the clock to tick down. But yes, it is wonderful music and singing. Liz Neri. And hi, Rochelle Drevko. Yes, Dolores does have a beautiful voice. Just a lilting, singing, wonderful voice. Linda Landry loves your beautiful voice. And Rajan Ferguson, I missed that. Anyway, there we go. So we still have a few minutes to go before I start the instruction on that. And where am I going to find Nick? Oh, there we are. Would you love me to sing with Dolores? I don't think I could do that. Different voices. Nick, do you sing at all yourself?
No.
I bet you do. I know your children do. So how do you not miss out on that?
I think I used to when I was small, and my uncle recorded me without me knowing it, and then I heard myself. I was maybe 12 or 13. When I heard myself, I thought, I gotta stop doing this. This is not good.
I think you're too hard on yourself.
I was too young to make that decision, really. You know, probably. But anyway.
There we go. Well, we love your guitar playing anyway.
Thank you.
Okay, so we have, how much time do we have before quiche is ready?
You 5 minutes.
5 minutes, so we have time for one song and maybe a short, did you want to do your short ditty? Everett, would you like to do that now? Okay, come on over, I have yes. lyrics. I have lyrics.
Are you good with the couch?
Well, you know
yeah,
what?
Yeah, I can sit, no, I'll sit on the couch, that's fine.
Okay.
And I'll just lean in.
So just a little background. I'll need to share that with you, by the way.
Sorry, Nick. Yes. For this number, I'll just have the two of them.
You want to play the guitar?
We normally do it
a cappella, but yeah,
no,
yeah.
I mean, but when we did it at Lewisburg, you
never
played,
mind.
Remember? Well, this is one actually that has become an ecumenical anthem for us. We do it both in English and in French. So it's multilingual as well as multi-denominational.
Love it.
And its claim to fame, of course, is that it was the last hymn sung by the crew and passengers of the Titanic.
Mm-hmm. Already.
So you might remember
yes,
from
yes,
the
yes,
movie.
Yes, 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 from the movie.
Remember that from
yes,
the movie?
Yes, I do.
Well, we sing both the English and the French. Why don't we do this? I'll sing the first verse in French. You join me on the chorus. And you sing the last verse in English, and I'll join you on the chorus.
Okay,
how's
so
that?
Just the two?
Yeah, we'll just
okay,
do
we'll
two,
give, we're
two
gonna,
verses.
We're going to give
as long
you
as you want, and then we still have time after
oh, yes,
for
okay.
one more.
Okay. So now we're flying by the seat of our pants, and we're doing something we didn't plan, but
well,
I didn't
well,
take
see, it's a kitchen. It's a kitchen party, kind of.
You know, this is the way I remember sitting in Mary Janet and Cecil's kitchen 35 years ago. Very relaxed and very ad-lib, and here we are. And we're going to sing something spiritual, just in case you might just like to hear that on a Sunday.
On a Sunday, that's right.
Okay, so I'll start, as I say, first verse in French, you join me on the chorus, and then last verse in English, I'll join you on the chorus. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mon Dieu, plus près de toi, plus près de toi. C'est le cri de ma foi, plus près de toi. Dans le jour où l'épreuve déborde comme un fleuve, garde-moi près de toi, plus près de toi.
Joyful wing cleaving the sky, sun, moon, and stars forgot, upward I fly.
Still all my song shall be nearer my God to thee. Nearer, my God, to thee, nearer to thee.
Oh my God.
Every bass.
Gives me chills. That was so beautiful. Thank you.
So anyhow, now you're blessed. You're good. You are good.
Oops. Oh, that's okay. That's me.
So maybe we should do Sunny's Dream.
We don't have time, do we?
Yes.
Time to get
go for it, okay. And we'll make it work.
In G, Nick. So Ron Hines was quite a songwriter and quite a character. And anybody who knew him just knew how absolutely funny he was. He one of these entertainers where you almost wanted him to finish the song so that you knew he was going to make you laugh. This song that he wrote when he was with the wonderful Grand Band put his kids through university, he would tell us. It's called Sunny's Dream.
Oh, love it.
Sunny lives on a farm in a wide open space. You can take off your sneakers. Don't go away, I am here all.
It's the party. I love it. I just love it. So, let's see if I can bring this up a little bit. Okay. There we go. Hi. That was amazing, wasn't it? Yeah, I know. Just, we just love people who have talent, and that's what it is. Okay, we're gonna make the potato pancakes and see how we get along with this. Let's see, we gotta get this the right way so that I can turn this down. There we go. All right, so I'm gonna get right at it. Okay. So I have, well, I kind of have a large potato, and it depends on how many you're feeding. So usually two medium-sized potatoes will make four little stacks of potato pancakes. I, since there'll be four of us eating, I have kind of a larger potato and two smaller ones. So I'm just gonna peel these. And anybody out there who's cringing their teeth or whatever, because I always use a knife when I peel my potatoes. I don't like using the little carrot peeler kind of thing. I don't like that. I was at a restaurant one time and I had, I guess perhaps it was called latke, because Elliot said that before. Is it latke?
Latke, yes, L-A-T-K-A.
And that is what? Is it from what country do they make them? Ukrainian or?
It's Jewish.
Jewish?
Israeli, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So I don't know that mine is anything like that, which I remember it being a nice, tidy little patty in the restaurant that I had it in. But I said, you know what? I'm going to do something like that because I think I like that. We love our potatoes in Cape Breton. So I'm just going to rinse these off in water first. And I am going to just dry them with paper towel. And I'm going to shred them, put them in the bowl. A great way to get rid of your nice manicured nails. By doing this. I'm putting it in the colander because I'm going to be rinsing it off, okay?
Now I'm just going to rinse it out a little bit just to get rid of a lot of that starch. I'll be right back. So I have a bunch of paper towel here, and I rinse that all off, and this is what I do, and I just soak up a lot of that water, so you don't want that, and that should be just fine. And in here, I'm going to whisk an egg. I'm going to add some pepper. I'm going to add some salt. I add a little poultry seasoning. You don't have to. You just want salt and pepper. I'm going to check on my quiche. I'm going to throw that in there. And our onion. Okay, that's all there is to the potato, and now we're going to bake it, but I'm just gonna check on my quiche now. Hold on a second. Quiche is ready. You can see that. And it's quite high just because of the egg will help make it rise, but it will settle down a little bit, and I'm just going to put it on the cookie rack there, and we'll serve it quite warm in a few minutes. And now we're going to stir up our potato pancakes. Okay. You can use in here, you can use, you can put bits of bacon in this, you can put green pepper in this, you can put, cheese in this. And I think one egg is plenty for that many potatoes that I used. Okay, we're gonna go over to the stove. Get a spoon. So what I'm going to do is going to add about a tablespoon of butter. I pretty much keep it on a pretty high flame, like medium high. You want a nice color. You know, French fry-y brown kind of thing. And mushrooms, yes, Holly, you know, that's whatever you want you can put in it. You can just make it your own. All right. Okay. Okay.
And you want to use butter. Butter makes it better. So I'm just going to take it. Put some stacks in there. You don't want it too thick because you want to be able to flatten it out some so that the potatoes cook. They're not going to be nice and round or anything like that. That's okay. So I'm just going to let them fry up a little bit. Turn you away from that bright light. There's another one. Okay, here. That's better. Not so much. So, does anybody have any questions? So next week, I'm just going to tell you what we're doing next week. Next week is going to be a quiet Sunday. We're not having any talent next week, unless somebody comes at the last minute or something like that. But next week, I'm going to be making Maid of Honor tarts. They're like a shortbread base, and there's some, you know, jam in the middle, and then kind of an Eagle Brand topping with coconut, and they're nice. And you need a little tartlet pan, or the tiny muffin pan. Oh, Sue? Really? Sue McMaster, your mom used to make the potato pancakes. All right. Were they made, Sue McMaster, I'm asking you, were they something similar to this? Because this is just my own concoction, and I've never found a recipe for it anywhere. I just started making it and liked what I made, you know. And just according to the tastes that we have. Better check this out. I don't want to burn them in front of you. Turn it down just a little bit. Okay, we'll put you over here. I'm just going to have a little peek here. Oh yeah, that's perfect on one side. They'll be messy, but that's a good thing. Now, I might turn them one more time. I'm not sure. I'll just see what I think. If I think the potatoes are nicely done throughout, I might turn them just one more time. But the underside, the very first one that that comes out, it's that side is nice and brown, and then the other side doesn't seem to get the same brownness. Okay, let me look at this. That's good. The what? Anyway, how was your week? Yes, they're round squares. Are you talking about the pancakes? They kind of are, aren't they? Darlene Turple, what squares are they? Sound yummy. I want to know about them too. Jam and Eagle Brand. Do I have a substitute for the egg? I don't. I wonder what else you could bind it with. You know what? I really, really don't know. If you don't eat eggs, it's a hard call because I really don't know what else would bind it together. You guys all like tea? Everybody likes tea.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you.
I'm gonna put the tea on. Or as I usually say, I'm gonna set the tea. Now, I push mine way back on the stove and then turn that burner on the lowest setting. And I think we're good. So, I'm just gonna put that on warm and just let it cook for a little bit more, and I'm going to get the plates ready for us. I'm going to ask Dolores and Nick to see if they have another song in them there. What do you think? Justin McDonnell, happy Sunday, everyone. So.
K42G.
There now. How are you guys doing? I think I have a kind of a crook.
We're good.
We're good. I hope you're hungry.
Yeah, sure. Smells so good. I could fill up on the smell. So as Mary Janet is setting up the camera for us, we're going to do another song. But I noticed that there were a couple of my relatives that came up on the Facebook site. And I just want all of my relatives to know that this is what you are getting for Christmas. Mary Janet's Tunes and Wooden Spoons. Mary Janet McDonald. Search the internet. I bought mine off Amazon. She's going to sign it today. But this is the perfect Christmas gift for those who enjoy being in the kitchen and serving the ones they love. What I like about these recipes is that I can buy all the ingredients at the local grocery store. So that's a good treat. Seems a brand new key. I asked my mother if you were at home. She said yes, but you weren't alone. Sometimes I think that you're avoiding me. I'm okay alone if you've got something I need. Well, I've got a brand new pair of roller skates. You got a brand new key. I think that we should get together and try them out.
So I invite you all to come to the table.
Oh, great.
Thank you.
I kind of have a mess going on here. But there is our quiche. I've just got to find my... I can't find my pie thing. So we have our potato pancake. I just have one on that plate, and we're going to have some biscuits. They're heating up in the microwave, and they look really good. Okay, so here you go.
Thank you.
And I'll get one for Dolores. We'll get to sit at the table.
And we have some biscuits.
And
let me see now. Dolores?
Yes.
I will get yours.
Okay. Thanks.
I hope you're hungry.
Mm, it smells divine.
Yeah, it does. Mm. And you won't have to cook supper tonight, Nick.
You're at the head, Nick.
I like the way that sounds.
There you go, Nick. Now, Dolores, I should be serving you first.
Ladies
the
first.
The ladies first, yeah. But here we are, the ladies are last.
You know, I well, get over that quickly. Privileged.
I
as long as you don't call me late for supper, we're good.
So, yeah, here we go.
Right there.
And I still have a potato pancake to make for. I can make for Cecil when he gets home.
Oh,
there you go.
Oh, wow.
And one for moi. Now, does everybody take milk in their tea?
Yes. Please.
No tea for me, thank you.
No tea for you? What can I get you?
Nothing. This is, you just got it.
Mm. All right. Here we go.
And there's mine.
Lovely.
Mm. All right, so I'm going to pour the tea. So three with milk?
Yes, please.
And... So you're heading back to Isle of Dam after this?
Yes, we are. Yeah, it's been a very busy week, so it'll be good to get a little downtime.
Yeah, it'll be great. Mm. I'm actually heading to Halifax after this.
Ah.
Right after this.
Oh my, that's a long road.
As well, I mentioned, Mary Jenna, the condiment, with latkes normally served are applesauce and sour cream.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it gives it that, you know, it gives it an additional flavor.
Oh, it would.
Yeah. Thank
you. Excuse me, there's your tea.
Well, I'll tell you, Mary Janet, this must be Cecil's favorite day of the week.
It is. And he blames his belly on me and making things, but it's his elbow that bends.
Yeah, yeah.
Glass of water, Nick?
Sure, yes.
Cheers. Thank you. Here's to your great cooking.
Oh, yes. There we go. Can you see these people, these beautiful people that come? Can I see Nick there?
Yeah, Nick.
Oh, yeah.
He's so shy.
Yeah.
Ha ha.
Shy of the camera. Yeah.
So here's to Tunes and Wooden Spoons, the show, the cookbook, the lady.
Indeed. Thank you.
Here you go. I'll drink to that.
Cheers. Yes.
Cheers. And teach you a Gaelic word, slancha.
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 Oh, I thought that was for something else in the teacup.
Well, you never know. We usually, when we're having a cup of tea, we'll say something about a strupak, which is a strupak. Effie explained it last weekend that the teapot, the spout on the teapot was called, I think she said a stroop, or something like that, and a little bit of that is a stroopak, and so often I heard that as a child, right? So anyway, there we go, people. Cheers to everybody there. Hi, Michelle Burgess. Well done, Dolores. That's Susan Lundy. She was here last week. She was on the Cape Breton tour. Yeah, and it was wonderful. Now, does anybody want ketchup or anything extra? No? Okay.
No.
So, it means to your health. There you go.
Too busy eating.
Hi, Sue.
With lactose, you would say l'chaim.
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 That's the cheer?
Yeah.
All right. So, everyone, it's come to the end of another show. I want to thank you all for joining me with this little visit, and thank you for coming to my house. Even though it's online, it's still, you're just as welcome as these three are here. And I'm just going to have a little taste. I'll taste the potato pancake first.
Yeah.
Very good. And the quiche.
Terrific.
Good.
I could live on the potato pancake.
We'll have to add that to my repertoire.
There you go. And this plate, of course, and these cups are my late friend, Marjorie. You'd remember Marjorie, Alex Teacher's wife?
Yes, I do.
So after she passed away, I mean, she was a very close friend, her children and her husband, Alec, they gave me these set of dishes to always remind me of her. And it was January of 2020, before COVID. But it's such a beautiful thing to do, because every time I look at the dishes, I think of her. And that's a great memory. Okay. Again, next Sunday, just us. And we'll make these Maid of Honor tarts, which Sharon Nicholson McCachran, who was here and made the apple galette with us, she's a Red Seal chef, and I'm making her recipe of the little tarts. So I think we should enjoy that. And as always, you know how much you matter to me. I'm with you every day, because I love going back and looking at the comments, and You give me just as much as I give you. And I just want you to love one another and know that I love you. Bye-bye, everybody, and see you next week. And thanks to Dolores and Nick and Elliot. They were a wonderful trio to bring to us from Isle Madame. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye now.
Hey, Hi, it's me, Charlie. If you like Grandma's video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe.